Hare Krishna. Even if you cut my body into pieces and I give up my life, I will never stop chanting Lord Hari's holy name. These were the words of Haridas Thakur. Lash him in 22 marketplaces until he dies. Beat him, drag him without any mercy till he bleeds to death. These were the words of the Qazi who shouted in great anger. Here is an extraordinary story of unimaginable devotion. Now I will narrate the wonderful activities of Srila Haridas Thakur. Whoever hears this narration will receive the full shelter of Lord Krishna. Taken from Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chapter 16, Adi Leela. Srila Haridas Thakur passed his time wandering on the banks of the Ganga, chanting the name of the Supreme Lord Krishna. The saint was held in full respect by the people of the village, and having won their trust, he lived there quite peacefully. The local Qazi became envious of Haridas Thakur's popularity and reported to the Nawab, "This man is acting like a Hindu. Arrest him and punish him appropriately." The envious words of the sinful Qazi sparked an immediate response from the equally sinful Nawab, and Haridas Thakur was arrested and brought forth. Haridas had no fear of the Muslim authorities, nor even of death itself. With the name of the Lord on his lips, Haridas appeared before the Nawab. Because of his purity, Srila Haridas Thakur radiated a certain effulgence which the Nawab could not fail to notice. He rose respectfully when Haridas entered and offered the saint a seat. The Nawab asked Haridas, "What sort of mentality has overcome you? Knowing you have the good fortune to become a Muslim, why do you behave like a Hindu? We do not even accept rice touched by a Hindu. Yet, you want to ignore your high birth and become a low caste Hindu? To discard your own race, land and religion for another is perverted. How do you expect to attain the liberated platform if you behave like this? I have decided to punish you according to the mandates of the Quran so that you will be freed from your sins." Haridas simply smiled at the Nawab and spoke in a sweet, soothing voice. "My dear sir, there is only one God for all living entities. The difference between the Muslim God and the Hindu God is in name only. According to knowledgeable Hindus and Muslims and every scriptures, be it Quran or Puran, God is one. He resides in everyone's heart. The Lord accepts everyone's individual mood of surrender towards Him. However, if one living entity feels hatred or envy toward another, he ultimately reflects those emotions in his relationship with the Lord. Whatever you see of me and my activities are direct manifestations of the Lord who guides me from within. A person may be born in a family of Brahmins, but despite his high birth, he demonstrates the perverted behavior of a fourth-class uncultured person. What can the Hindus do with such a person? He is forced to act in degrading ways because of his innate propensities, and he accordingly suffers or enjoys the reactions of his activities. What could be achieved by punishing him for activities which are an intrinsic part of his nature? My dear respected sir, please consider these points seriously, and if you still find me guilty, then punish me." The Muslim courtiers were sincerely moved by the honesty of Haridas Thakur's words and presence. But his wisdom could not penetrate the envious and sinful heart of the Qazi, who turned to the Nawab and instructed, "You must punish this man. He is evil and mischievous. Others will fall under his influence and become equally sinful. He will disgrace our Muslim religion and community. Therefore, he must be appropriately punished. If he wants to be excused, then let him preach from his own scripture." The Nawab tried again, "My friend, just speak from your own scripture and accept the path. Then you will have nothing to fear. Otherwise, the Qazi's present will force me to punish you, they will revile and insult you. Why should you let that happen? Whatever the Supreme Lord desires is destined to happen. There is no one who can check it, replied Haridas. Each one of us suffers according to the degree of his previous offenses. You should know without a doubt that you are merely an instrument of the Lord's desire. Even if my body is cut into pieces and I lose my life, I will never give up chanting the Lord's holy name. The Nawab heard the fearless reply of Srila Haridas Thakur and turned to the Qazi. Now what is your decision about him? The Qazi said, lash him in 22 marketplaces until he dies. There is no other judgment I find appropriate. If he lives despite the punishment, then I will conclude that our big scholar has spoken the truth. The sentries were called in and the orders boomed out. Lash him until he breathes his last. The sin a Muslim incurs by becoming a Hindu can only be punished by death. Srila Haridas was dragged away by the sentries. From one marketplace to another, they beat him mercilessly, their black hearts consumed by hate for the pure devotee of the Lord. But Haridas was a pure soul, completely surrendered to the Supreme Lord. So he faithfully chanted Lord Krishna's holy name. So absorbed was he in his fervent chanting that he did not feel any pain. Good-hearted and pious people could not bear to see the torture inflicted on such an innocent person. Some begged the sentries to stop, while others predicted, if they continue to torture this good man, the entire kingdom will be ruined. Many of them cursed the king to die, while some tried to stop the sentries physically. One person threw himself at the feet of the sentries and pleaded, I will give you any reward you like if you stop this merciless beating. But none of these protests evoked the slightest mercy from the sentries who continued to drag Srila Haridas Thakur from one marketplace to another, lashing him relentlessly. By the grace of Lord Krishna, Haridas felt little pain in his body. Just like Prahlad in the Srimad Bhagavatam, who was tortured by demons, Haridas never suffered at all. Not only was Haridas freed from his pain, whoever remembers this story of Srila Haridas will also be saved from the miseries of life. Throughout his ordeal, Haridas's one emotion was pity for the sentries. He prayed, O Lord Krishna, please be merciful upon these poor souls so they may not be punished because of me. Nothing could stop the insensitive sentries who were determined to see their assignment through to its deadly end. Yet, for all their beating, Haridas showed no signs of distress as he was absorbed in remembering the holy name of Lord Krishna. At last, the guards had to stop in amazement. How can a human being survive such a brutal beating? Any ordinary man would have died after the beating we gave in the first two or three marketplaces. We have lashed him continuously throughout 22 marketplaces, and he still shows no sign of either pain or death. Occasionally, he looks up to smile at us. They concluded that he must be a saintly person. O Haridas, they pleaded, because of you, we shall certainly be punished. When the Qazi sees that despite our beating, you are still alive, he shall certainly kill us instead. Haridas replied, if my survival brings such terrible misfortune to you, then I shall definitely give up my body. Just see how I die. Srila Haridas Thakur immediately fell into trance. Immediately, Srila Haridas fell lifeless, without a trace of breath. The Muslim sentries were astonished, but gladly brought the body of Srila Haridas to the Nawab. When the Nawab ordered the sentries to bury him, the Qazi protested, No, if he is buried, he will be saved and ultimately gain entrance into heaven. Although he got the high birth of a Muslim, he behaved like a low Hindu. Therefore, it is proper for him to be thrown in the Ganga, to suffer eternally like the other lost Hindus. By being buried, he will become elevated and free from his sin. On the Qazi's order, the sentries picked up the body of Haridas Thakur and carried him to the Ganga. The spirit of Lord Krishna then descended into the body of Srila Thakur and he became so heavy that it was impossible to move him. The strongest sentries came forward to push him into the waters, but he could not be moved. Srila Haridas Thakur could have escaped the punishment of the Muslims, but by allowing them to torture him, he taught the world a lesson. Despite the extreme miseries of life, one must never stop chanting the name of Krishna. Haridas Thakur was directly protected by the Supreme Lord Krishna. Therefore, who could harm him? If one simply remembers the name of Haridas, not to mention his terrible ordeal at the hands of the Muslims, he becomes free from his own pain and misery. Most certainly, Srila Haridas Thakur was one of the closest and most important associates of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Chaitanya Chandra. Haridas floated downstream on the currents of the Ganga, and after some time, he became conscious by the Lord's desire. Fully awakened and overwhelmed with ecstasy, he climbed the bank of the Ganga, loudly chanting the name of Krishna as he walked. When the Muslims saw Srila Haridas, they were convinced that he possessed extraordinary mystic powers. Pure happy feelings replaced the envy and hate in their hearts. They offered him obeisances, worshipping him as a very saintly person. By this worship, the Muslims became free from material entanglement. In the presence of the Nawab, Haridas smiled compassionately at the Muslim ruler who was standing respectfully with folded hands. In a humble and meek voice, the Nawab said, "I can now understand that you are truly a saintly person. You have realized the absolute truth and you have seen the one Supreme Lord. Absolute knowledge and liberation has been attained by you. I have come just to see you, simply to beg forgiveness. Kindly forgive me for the offenses I have committed against you. Because you see everyone equally, you have neither friends nor enemies. You are a free man in every respect. You may stay wherever you wish, in a lonely hut or a cave or on the bank of the river Ganga. But please be merciful upon those of us who have committed this great offense against you." The Muslims had been angry enough to kill him. Yet, they were transformed and they worshipped his feet, accepting him as a holy man. Chant Hare Krishna mantra and share the glories of Sri Krishna's devotees, the glories of Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.